Welcome to another weekly episode with me, Matt Peacock. It's great to have you with me. Now today, I'm going to be talking you through how to build a deck. And we've got this space here, we've got a bit of concrete, and we've got a bit of grass as well. So we're going to be pegging straight onto the concrete and digging posts for our pegs into the ground. So stay tuned, you're going to watch this deck go up in no time at all. And I'm going to give you some helpful principles in how to do that. Okay, so as you can see, we've now well underway with our frame. Now, with your frame, you can build it out of 4x2s like we have done, or 6x2s. The reason why we've gone for 4x2s today is simply that at the end of the house, there was not enough room to go for a 6x2. So we've got it all out of 4x2, which is still very strong. And the first thing you'll do, if you've got a fix that you can get to your house, or any kind of solid state, fix to that straight off and then run your frame off of that. You'll get the most secure and it's helpful with the levels as well. So first of all, build the outside frame, and then second of all, if you see, we've got our beams running across here. Now we've run them at 400 mil, 40 centimeters each, and you'll see the next step very shortly. So this is what you want to achieve by now. We're using decking screws, you could use a nail gun, but we've gone for decking screws, and we, for each fix, we're using 3 screws. So we've got a couple in here, one in here. What we've also done at this stage, because this end is higher, we've had to put a few pegs in. So we've got one here, and they're a mixture of 4x4s and 3x3s. Right, okay, so the deck frame is now built, and we've pegged it all. So the pegs, this little bit, we've got 3 to 4 pegs per line. That stops the sponginess, that stops the frame from bouncing, so I can jump on, and it's not gonna jump down, which is what you want for when you put your decking boards. Alongside that, this is what we call in the trade noggins. Funny name, eh? And we've staggered them, 2s and 3s, so 2 for one line, 3 the next, and so on. That brings the extra stability between the struts going across, and so much needed. We've also weed killed the grass underneath and laid a weed mat membrane to prevent any grass or any weeds coming up through the decking boards. That's the last thing you want. So now all that leaves us to do is to start laying our decking boards. So here we go. Okay, so as you can see, I've already started to put the decking planks on. Now we're fixing to each line across, that you can see. Now we're using decking screws. You could use a nail gun. They are faster, however they are less forgiving. So if you make a mistake, you can sometimes lose your board because it rips it, as opposed to just drilling back up the screws that you might need to take up if you need to move your board again. So when putting down the boards, I use 2 of these spacers, and they're just 2 drill bits, and it means that I can put them in and I've got an equal distance between each board going all across. Now what you'll probably find, you'll be very fortunate if you get decking boards which are perfectly straight. Okay, so they've been lying in the timber yard, or you may have had them at your house for a few days, and they may have got a little bit of curvature. So using these along with a little bit of brute force just to push them in will help you get a really nice finish, which is what you want. Now the other key to this is taking very precise measurements. I recommend that you work in millimeters. You can get down to the finest reading that you want. Now we're using just 1 board per length. Sometimes we'll do 2 and we'll stagger it, but this does mean less cutting, and we are working very precisely from side to side, and so make sure you take really good readings. So we're about nearly halfway there on this one, and we've done a cut around the fence post. We've got a drain pipe and the door that we're going to be working around, and so you'll see now the completed version. So here we have it, the deck is done. All the decking boards are down. We have trickily navigated our way around things like the pipe in the corner, And also the door, we want it to get flush right underneath, so we have to plane a little bit off, get the right measurements, in order that this is a crisp, amazing finish, that the deck who they're built for, that they'll tell all of their friends about this. I hope you do the same. I hope it's been really, really helpful for you. Please share this with your friends, family, on all your social media platforms. It's great to have you with me. I love giving you this information, all for the very expensive cost of free. And I look forward to being in touch with you. Please sign up to my newsletter, and I'd love maybe even to come do a free lawn mow for you if you're in Bedford, England, that is. So yeah, so please do be in contact. And until the next video, I'll see you then. Bye-bye now.